Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to solve a given equation or formula for a specific variable. So here I have this formula, no idea what it really stands for here. A equals negative fmn over k squared. And what we're going to do is we're going to solve this for n, so for little n right there. So essentially what they're wanting here is instead of having this equation set up in this way here, they want this to look like n equals so-and-so. All right, so every once in a while we're given some kind of equation or something like that. You know, maybe it's a known equation, you know, that's set to solve a specific thing, but we may not want it actually solved for what it is typically solved for. We may want it solved for something else. So we have to maybe know how to move some things around. How do we rearrange the formula so that it is set up to solve for what we're needing? So for this equation here, we're needing it to be solved for little n right over here. So we want it to be n equals. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to use some of our solving equation skills to take this formula here and rearrange it around to where it looks different. So for a minute, let's just try and pretend maybe everything else is a number in this equation except for n. How would we solve for n? How would we get n all by itself? So let's go through this process here. Now, if I'm trying to solve for n, and I'm trying to get n all by itself, the first thing that I notice here, the most obvious to me, is the fact that I have a fraction here. And let's be honest, most of us don't like to deal with fractions, so let's get rid of this fraction. So getting rid of this fraction here is also going to help us by thinking, hey, remember that even though this is a fraction, fractions also are a division. I have this numerator that's being divided by that k squared. So if this is a division, right, that's going to help us because if I'm trying to use my solving equation skills to rearrange this and get it solved for n, remember in solving equations that we typically do the opposite of what we have. Now, if I have division, the opposite of division is multiplication. So instead of dividing by k squared, what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply by k squared. And that's going to be the first step that I do here. I'm going to multiply both sides by k squared because on the right-hand side here, k squared and k squared are going to cancel out, leaving me with negative fmn. And on the left-hand side, I had a, and now I'm multiplying it by k squared. A and k squared are not the same variable. They're not like terms or anything like that. I can't actually multiply them together, so I just kind of squish them together there. So that would be my first step there. Now my second step, so let's see, I'm still trying to get n by itself, but keep in mind, really what I have here, I have negative f times m times n. All right, so this is really all multiplication over here. So again, keeping with our solving equation skills, solving equations, we do the opposite of what we have. So instead of multiplication, I want to divide. And since this is all multiplication, I'm going to divide everything except the n. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide both sides by the negative, by the f, by the m. And remember that what we do to one side, we must do to the other side as well. Now, this is why I'm wanting to do that there. So when I divide here, notice that a negative divided by a negative cancels, f over f cancels, m over m cancels. So on the right-hand side, all I have left is the n. And on the left-hand side, well, we had a k squared. And then we divided it by a negative fm. So just kind of keep, you know, just compile that all together. Again, none of these variables, none of these letters are the same. We can't actually combine them or calculate them together. So we had a k squared, we're dividing it by the negative fm. So literally just put that all together there. And now when I step back and I look at this, well, I have it solved for n. N equals negative ak squared over fm. And this would be my final solution here. This would be the end equation that I'm looking for, because we wanted to take this original equation over here, rearrange it around to where it's solved just for the end there. So just pretend that this is just a regular equation. How would you get that specific variable by itself? Remembering to do the opposite of what you have going on.